minus 1 minute.
T minus 1 minute and counting. The hydrogen igniters under the orbiter's engines have been armed. These devices are used to ensure that any hydrogen flowing through the engines does not accumulate. T minus 45 seconds. We're just 18 seconds away from switching command of the countdown from the ground computers to the onboard computers.
T minus 31 seconds,
and we're switching control of the countdown to the onboard computers. T minus 25 seconds. Sequencer is now controlling the final second. T minus 20 seconds, Mark. T minus 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10. We're go for main engine start. 7, 6, we have main engine start. 3, 2, 1, and liftoff of Discovery.
Thank you. Discovery. We're going MET zero for the EVA now. They're going to power to that.
Roger, copy. We'll call it 0110.
Roger that.
And Dale, it is right there, my friend.
Great.
We could go get it right as she stands. Could let me out on a cable. I could grab it. Gorgeous. Helicopter would go grab that. It's too smooth and steady. That's your job.
Okay, guys, they're still rendezvousing in here, and it's all coming into the cabin.
Okay.
Joseph, you're at the MU. Joseph, are you at the MU?
That's a firm.
Good. Just proceed on through and give me a call at step 9.
This is Mission Control. They're progressing very well with the EVA, preparing to do the flight check with the Stinger on the MMU.
Okay, now, where am I? No, wait, don't do that. No, I'm going to back up. Can I just back up? I go forward for a little bit.
Okay,
pitch down so you can see where you're at.
Okay. You can go a little higher so you can clear the tail.
Don't want to get too close to the satellite, jeez.
Okay, a little higher. We got about 2 feet between you and the Stinger.
Talking to.
I'm sorry, I'm talking to Joe.
I thought you were going to tell me about the ram me.
No.
Okay.
Joe, translate forward a little bit, please.
Still. Wow, look at that.
Houston Discovery, the sun is up and we're ready to go.
Roger, copy that, David. We're ready also. Things are proceeding very well in the EVA. The crewmen were holding up. They're waiting for daylight to illuminate the satellite in the orbiter's cargo bay, so they'll have good lighting conditions for the docking maneuver. Mission specialist Joe Allen on the MMU with the Stinger attached to the front will fly around to the back end of the orbiter and insert the Stinger into the rocket nozzle. The used rocket nozzle of the Palapa satellite, and he'll then trigger the toggle bolts and tighten the grip on the satellite. The mechanical arm operated by mission specialist Anna Fisher will then grapple a connecting fixture on the side of the Stinger, and then we'll haul the satellite and Joe Allen attached to it back down toward the cargo bay, where Guy Gardner, or rather Dale Gardner, will attach an A-frame structure to the top of the satellite that will enable it to be grabbed by the mechanical arm from the top, and then insert it tail down into a retaining fixture in the cargo bay, where it will be firmly mounted for the return to Earth.
Okay, I'm lined up pretty well behind it. Into it,
but it's not in a nasty position.
The closing rate's about right. Okay, I almost can't see it. I'm flying right into the sun.
Have you, sir?
And how?
Cabot.
Good work, Cabot. Way to go. That doggy's on the ground and we're putting the rope around its feet.
Gardner will be moving into the A-frame installation here in a few minutes.
Okay, Anna. I need to do a little bit of orbiter pitch up.
Hey, Dale, I'm working real close to the wrist jaw singularity.
Okay.
Can I just try to bring it down?
Okay, can you come down towards me?
Yeah, I'm going to do that.
Okay, stop. Hey, can you go towards my head now for about 6 or 8 inches? Okay, let's hold it right there. Brakes on, Anna.
Discovery, Houston.
Go ahead.
Roger, we're going LOS, and we'll see you at Guam at 3-1.
Hey, we're LOS. Tell you what, the sun really hot. We're LOS, aren't we? It's hot. David, are you there?
pine cone. Nice, longing for life. Wind winding, coning down the ground. Life's love for life. Waves of waving purples and yellows. Singing chimes on my eyes. Yellow purple, symbiotic spectrums. Bluebell slowly. The sounds of growing. Fragrant fertility, flowering my imagination. Canopies of greens, painted on a blue canvas. Fallen trees, fertile ground. Rotting life, living death. Clouds appearing through the green, disappearing through the green. The color of kindled lips, the permanence of high surface. Thank you.
Mission Control Houston, Hawaii. Data now shows Discovery at 477,000 feet, velocity 24,400 feet per second. Now 4,552 nautical miles from the runway. Touchdown 30 minutes away.
Discovery Houston, 45 seconds LOS via JSC. We're watching NASA Select. We're looking at lots of blue sky from the SLS.
This is Shuttle Recovery Control with a brief update on landing preparations here at the Kennedy Space Center. The recovery team is ready and standing by to welcome the orbiter home. In the last few minutes, the safety assessment team has been suiting up in special protective clothing. That team will be the first to approach the orbiter after it has come to a stop on the shuttle landing facility. During the early safety assessment, the crew aboard Discovery will be busy themselves with a series of initial safety and reconfiguration activities. And we would expect the 51A crew to be stepping out for KSC's red carpet welcome about a half hour or so after landing, marking the start of Discovery's turnaround for its next flight. All is ready here at KSC for Discovery's landing, which is just minutes away now. We return now to Mission Control Houston as we follow Discovery's progress towards Florida.
Mission Control Houston, Discovery now passing due east of Victoria, Texas. We still have non-established communication through the JSC ground station. Pre-mission pre-decks show velocity of Discovery now 18,500 feet per second at an altitude of 205,000 feet, about 1,043 nautical miles from touchdown. Mission Control Houston GC officer reports we're locked on install the JSC ground station and taking data.
Discovery Houston with you through JSC, configure AOS.
Thank you.
Lights down. Nose gear now coming down. Cuts down. Discovery now rolling out. Runway 15 at the Kennedy Space Center. After a 2.5 million mile service call, the crew of 51A is home.
We launched on November 8th, about 3 months ago today, and here you see the three main engines igniting. They ignite about 6 seconds prior to the solid rockets, which are on either side of the external tank. As you may be aware, we did have a launch delay of one day due to high altitude winds because we're concerned about structural damage with those high winds. However, when those solid rockets ignite, you certainly know that you are going somewhere. It's definitely a rattling type ride as you're going, but certainly nothing alarming, and really much smoother than you might expect with that much thrust. There's over 7 million pounds of thrust coming from the combination of the three main engines and the two solid rockets on either side. As you can see, we launched on a cloudy day, and many of my guests said that they weren't able to watch the launch as long as they had on previous missions. This is the trail of smoke that's left behind, and I think it's a good idea that you don't see that from inside the cockpit. We then continue on for 2 minutes, a little over 2 minutes, burning the solid rockets up to about a height of 53 nautical miles. At that point, the solid rockets are jettisoned, and the main engines continue burning for another 6.5 minutes. This is the view that greets you once you're on orbit. It is indeed, as I mentioned, a spectacular view, one that all of us in the astronaut corps feel very privileged to see. Let me just introduce the crew here. This is our commander, Rick Hauck, a Navy captain, and was a very privilege to work with him. Captain Dave Walker, our pilot, flew in the right seat. Joe Allen was Mission Specialist 1. Myself, who was a flight engineer on this mission and operated the mechanical arm. Joe Allen, I can mention, was one of the ones who was going to do the spacewalk. And Dale Gardner, also the Mission Specialist 3, who would be participating in the spacewalks that I mentioned. On flight day 3, we deployed the CINCOM satellite. It is the orbiter is oriented towards the Earth, and it is ejected from the payload bay in what is called a frisbee style, which you see here. It's a very large satellite. It weighs about 13 feet diameter.